Forget me before spring cleaning comes.
Wendy stood at the window of her daughter's nursery and watched the evening stars winking at one another. Wendy was a grown-up now, and though it had been many years since she and Peter last saw one another, Wendy still remembered perfectly that night they bid farewell. Wendy's daughter, Jane, entered the room, dressed in her sleeping gown and nightcap.
Not tonight, my dear.
Oh, but he has to come some night soon and teach me to fly, and then whisk me away to Never Neverland. Will he ever come for me, Mother?
That isn't for me to say, Jane.
Jane nestled against her mother and stared longingly into the evening sky.
The second star to the right shines in the night for you, to tell you that the dreams you
Peter must be very busy in Neverland tonight. It's off to bed for you.
Only if you sing me Peter's song first.
Peter's song?
Once upon a time and long ago.
How do you know that?
Sometimes when you think you're alone and no one's listening, I've heard you singing it.
But Jane?
Did Peter teach it to you?
He sang it one night for the Lost Boys.
Sing it for me, Mother.
Oh, Jane, I don't think I could.
Just remember back to how you heard Peter sing it. Mother, please try.
Once upon a time and long ago, I heard someone singing soft and low. Now when day is done and night is near, I recall this song I used to hear.
My child, my very own, don't be afraid, you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well.
Long ago this song was sung to me. I used to know, once upon a time and long ago. My child, my very own, don't be afraid, you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well.
Jane had fallen fast asleep. Wendy kissed her lightly on the forehead, looked once more out of the window into the starlit night.
Good night, Peter.
And tiptoed silently out of the room.